And next up, we have Jouko from Bitbar to talk about using image recognition for mobile app and game testing.
Hello. Okay, so my name is Jouko Kaasila. I'm the co-founder and COO of Bitbar, the company behind a pretty awesome online service called Testdroid Cloud, which is it's a device cloud of Android and iOS devices from every single market in the world, including Japan, China, Korea, and India. We also host private device clouds for people who don't want to share their devices, and we license our technology to companies who build large-scale on-premise device labs. So in the next 10 minutes, I'm going to tell you how to get rid of 60 manual testers and replace them with one smart one. And this is actually something that has happened with one of our customer organizations. When they moved from 100% manual testing using real devices to 100% automated testing using real devices. And at the end, I'm going to have a gift for all of you in the spirit of the holiday season. So let's start. So if you look at the chart of the most crossing apps on the Android or the Google Play today, on the top 50 of list of the most crossing apps, there is only one app that is not a game. And if you look at the top 100 most crossing apps, there are only three apps that are not the games. So it's pretty obvious who's making the money on the app stores. And usually games are free to download, and they monetize with in-app purchases. So it takes a little bit of time, or you have to engage the user long enough to make really any money on that. Because currently, the average customer acquisition cost, or the cost per download on Android and iOS is around $5. So it means that you have to keep the customer for long as many releases as possible in order to recover that $5 investment and make some profit on top of it. So it's very high motivation for testing in general and making sure that your game works on every single device out there. So given the commercial incentive, why hasn't this all been automated long time ago? You know, these guys do have a lot of money. That's not the problem. So the problem is that mobile games are not really easy to automate. They are very difficult to automate. So the main reason is that the games use direct screen access in the form of OpenGL or ActiveX, and they effectively bypass all the operating system controls or services you have. So that means that any of the mobile native mobile test automation frameworks that we all know can't really access any of the internal data of the game. So you only have to resort to X and Y clicks and, you know, reading the screen buffer. You know, you basically have to test everything from the outside of the game. And of course, in terms of automation, that's pretty tricky. The second thing is that the games are very performance driven. So first of all, they consume a lot of resources. So the game binaries are 2 to 3 gigabytes today. They use a lot of network traffic. They use a lot of memory. They use a lot of CPU. They use a lot of GPU. They utilize the sensors. So it's pretty clear that, you know, these guys, they don't test anything on emulators and simulators. It doesn't just make any sense. And there's another interesting incentive is that one of our customers told us that, you know, if they can add one more very popular Chinese Android device on the list of their supported devices, it can bring up to 5 million revenues over the lifetime of the game. So you can invest quite a lot on optimizing your game on that model. So all the difficulties have actually led to this. So the guys have resources, and it's difficult to automate games. So all the gaming companies, the large gaming companies, have very large manual device farms on their favorite low-cost locations. And that, of course, leads, you know, it doesn't scale very well. And that leads to another problem, that the QA process causes delays on the actual release of the game, which increases the time to market. And that's the real cost of the manual testing, that you know, things get delayed and you don't stick to the schedule. And of course, even with games, there's still a lot of room for manual testing. But that space is more for the qualitative, you know, testing of the fluidity of the gameplay, that sort of aspects. Not to go through every single menu on every single language on every single device. That's the job for the automation. So the most typical assignment we get is that, you know, guys, we only need to automate the basic game, basic functionality of the game. So on as many devices as possible, and it has to run as fast as possible because they want to automate it on every single build. And of course, with these guys, the challenge is never the access to the devices. You know, for the manual testing, they have hundreds of devices. That's not a problem. The problem is that how to automate these like monotonous routines, and especially in a way that they produce actionable results, in such as performance data logs, screenshots, and videos at scale. You know, with manual testing, you can get those like one by one, but you can't get it at scale. Another curveball is that, of course, these teams, they don't have like programming skills or background on scripting, which severely limits the tools and the frameworks that can be used. And also, these guys are, you know, these teams are usually quite separated from the actual development team. So any kind of like white box testing or instrumenting the game itself is not usually feasible for these guys. These guys get the APK thrown over the fence, and it's like pure 100% black box testing scenario. So with these two requirements in mind, need for like very simple scripting without any computer science skills, and the pure 100% black box approach, we started looking at the open source space, that, you know, what sort of building blocks could we find to gobble up a solution that actually solves this, this sort of problem. So as a foundation of the solution, we selected Appium. And the fact that Appium is cross-platform test automation framework works really well here, because usually the game is exactly the same on Android and iOS. So in ideal case, you can use the same script to run your automation on both Android and iOS. Also, Appium provides a pretty nice abstracted API that we can use for the next level of our automation to run. So in this scenario, we cannot use any of the like advanced features of Appium, like the object inspecting the object and that sort of things. We can only use like X and Y clicks and drags. For the next level, we had to kind of figure out three things. How can we know where in the game flow we are? How can we get that info? Then when we get that info, where should we click next? What is the next X and Y coordinate to click? And then after we have clicked something, did we achieve what we wanted to do? Did the game go to the next stage as we expected? So to drive the test execution from 100% from the outside of the game, we selected OpenCV image recognition library. So basically, we feed the library with screenshots and reference images, and it does like a pixel comparison, pixel matching. And when it finds the matching location, it will feed the X and Y coordinates to the Appium script that then executes that on the real devices. It's pretty, the OpenCV library is very good for this, because it's customizable. It's resolution agnostic, which is really good on real mobile testing, or like real device testing context. And it can even recognize images that are stretched or like somehow at an angle. So you can even test like 3D games as well. So the outcome is that there's only two simple tasks that the test automation engineers need to do. they need to cut the reference images and then change only like one line or like one line of code on to define what kind of click needs to be done when the reference is matching or when you get the coordinates. So then parallelizing this was quite interesting. So in the device cloud, like remote device cloud context, the Appium client sits on the remote machine, which is typically a developer workstation or a mobile or continuous integration server on the other side of the internet, where the devices are. And this, you know, Appium creates web driver session from the Appium client to the Appium server, which is on the cloud, and then, you know, using that server, all the data goes over the web driver session, including the logs and the screenshots and all the control commands. And the way you scale this is that you just spin a lot of web driver sessions on the same remote machine, and you know you just keep running it. But that effectively renders the remote machine the bottleneck. And especially in our scenario where we run the OpenCV image recognition stack on top of the Appium client, and we're transferring very large screenshots all the time on all the devices, we really hit performance for wall on like 5, 6, 7 devices per remote machine. It didn't scale. We had to look for something else. So our solution was that we moved all the processing, the whole test execution on the server side. So we created virtual machine images that included the whole stack, including the OpenCV, the Appium client, and Appium server. And this virtual machine automatically connects to like just one individual Android or iOS device at a time. Then we can run a lot of these on one physical server. We can run as many of these as we want. And the server has enough processing power to do all the pixel comparison, all that. We don't have to transfer the screenshots over the internet, and actually it's actually made this very robust and very fast. So in a way it's like Appium grid on steroids, because you know it runs like 3 times faster than your normal Appium, and it's really really scalable, and the end user doesn't have to worry of any of the how to spin these up and how to scale. From the end user point of view, it's like running one session. They upload just one script and it runs, you know, their online system scales all that execution for them. So we prepared a demo on how all this works in practice. So can we start the video? Okay, so that's a demo, and And as promised, the gift, all the sample code, all the instructions, everything, you can get access to those at testdroid.com/GTAC2015. Questions?
Sadly, we actually don't have time for questions.
Good.
Because you are standing between these people. Good. Well, yeah, and you're standing between these people and food.
Yes, and you can reach me today and tomorrow. I'm going to be here all day. So any questions on automating game testing or scaling Appium on the server side, just reach me.
Great. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.